Okay, so as a final stage, let's make a couple of renders out of this object. First of all, I want to prepare the scene. I will move this wireframe texture. And I will hide this backdrop and put the camera view. This will be our view. So I will start item by item. Let's start, say, with this and this. This will be a tar material, something like a rubber material. So I'll switch to polygon mode, press M, and I'll give it a material name. Let's name it tile. Okay, here's our material. Now for the rim, I'll do the same. I hit M and call it rim. Next will be breaking disc. Hit M and name it breaking disc. Another one will be this piece. I'll assign a material and name it disc inside, for example. And I would say last, this will be the caliper. So I will name this material caliper. Here are our materials. I give in materials to the entire item, but this will not be correct, or at least will not be so visually pleasing for the eye. So I need more variation. For example, in the rim, I want to give this a different material. So I select this polys, shift up arrow, and make a material. I'll name it metal 2. Same goes for this ring. This will be metal 2. And same goes for the Audi logo. Metal 2 as well. Another material would be from this piece. Let's select here each one of these kind of screws. So I'm selecting just the top of it. Now shift up arrow to expand the selection and apply the metal 2 material. Now I'm going for the caliper. First thing I want is the rainbow logo. So I will select all the polygons that belongs to the logo on the side and also the opposite side. So I make a new material, hit M, and I'll call it rainbow logo. This screw, this one, all these screws will be assigned to the Metal 2 logo as well. So, Metal 2. What else? This tube. I want it to be a different material. So I'm gonna select it and hit M and call it Tube. and it's salt. All the materials are assigned. Now, when I do these kind of scenes, one thing I do is go selecting all the materials one by one and just give it some random color, just a weird color. Let's say I put this in red, rainbow logo would be green, the metal 2 would be some blue, the caliper can be yellow, and so on. This will be purple. Breaking disc will be some light blue. Now the rim will be orange, and the tire can be its original color, I guess. The reason to do this is because the next step will be applying real materials. So in just one side, I will know for sure what materials are assigned and what are not, just by looking at what weird colors are present in this scene. By the way, I'm seeing this material, this piece and this piece. I want it to be the same material down the tire, so I'll select it, the opposite side as well. Okay, hit M and assign it to the tire material. That's it. Okay, so we are now prepared to start applying materials. Let's open the preview render and see what we have. And this is what we have. First thing I do is disable the directional light. In case it is enabled, it is disabled. So I leave it as it is. And then we'll add on the presets panel, I will add an environment. It doesn't matter indoors, outdoors, or whatever. We just need a good HDRI. I want to use the kitchen. This is one environment I like to use in most situations. So there's, come on, there's our environment. And with this environment, I want it to be invisible to camera. So in its properties, I will untick the visible to camera. So now we can start from here. First thing, before applying materials, we'll be assigning a proper color space. So we'll go into the final color output. And in properties, here you see the output color space. I like to work in a linear workspace. That's it, with a gamma output of 2.2. This will assure us that we have the maximum amount of information in your render. So later you can tweak it in Photoshop to give it more contrast or whatever. Now in the exposure control, I'll go to photographic exposure control. In white level, I like to use the photographic and lower it. Something about so. So from here we can start working in the materials. Let's start with the rim. We'll open the presets panel, go to materials, and then into materials I'm going to metals, and I would say maybe titanium, none of this. Maybe this cast titanium, I like this material for the rims. So I'm gonna drag this from the presets panel directly into the rim material. So here's a preset, and that's the result. That's it. This is a ring material. Now the next thing I want to assign a material to will be this metal 2. This is a metal 2 material, and I'd say maybe steel. Let's say we did stainless steel. So drag it into metal 2. Let's see what we have. I don't like it so much. It's not very different. We're going to tweak the material. Yes, I like this much more.